from your brother.
I
Smith, playing for the Cottonmouths in the CHL game, number 29, Roman Marikowski. At goaltender, his number 30 name to the Raptors here, one of the great members of the CHL Cottonmouths, a 1998 champion and the 2000 CHL Goaltender of the Year, number 30, Frankie the Wolverine. That forward, a member of the Cottonmouths in the CHL, and came back to be the captain in the SCHL, a 2005 champion with the Cottonmouths, number 32, Greg Stahl. That goaltender, a member of the 2012 championship Cottonmouths team, and the MVP of that postseason, number 40, E.O.B.J. And on defense, a member of the CHL championship team back in 1998, he came back as assistant coach for the 2012 championship team in the SB, number 55, Brad Tremonti. Toolman 3. for number 33, Yaroslav, Jimmy Kavrinsky. And at forward, a member of your 1998 CHL champions, known as smooth skating around the league, welcome back number 61, Holy Jensen.
Tom Callahan here with you, and you know what? Sometimes you get a couple guys who aren't on the roster, some late adds. That's what happened this year with the River Dragons and the Cottonmouths alumni. There we go. Get a couple of intros in there. So we are going to have a lot of duplicate numbers. Well, we're going to try to keep everybody straight as best we can for you here as we get ready for our anthem before the game. In the books here, and we're going to get ready to go. And this is, if you're just joining us and wondering what game is this, this is the Legends of Columbus Hockey. It's all actually this year centered around a new fixture, and that is Jerome Bichard Day, which officially was yesterday but extends into the weekend. The Legends of Columbus Hockey are here to play this afternoon, both from the Cottonmouths days and from the River Dragons days. So as I mentioned, there's going to be duplicate jersey numbers. There's going to be duplicate names. I'm going to try to keep them all straight for you and try to even figure out who's in what net here. All right, so Team Starry is the white team. Team Pepsi is the black jersey team. By the way, those Legends jerseys are available for auction on the Dash app. And we did a little mic'd up earlier today with Jerome Bichard, the morning skate, and the River Dragons and the Legends who wanted to do skate were out there this morning. So we'll have that in the first intermission of tonight's River Dragons game for you. That should be an awful lot of fun. And I don't know if we're going to get the fisticuffs right off the hop here, but I did hear some of the boys talking about that a little bit. We'll see how this one goes. It's interesting, looking down, I see quite a few of the old Snakes jerseys out there. We got a Bathgate, a Vigée, a Williams, a Green, a Prefontaine. And that's just in the couple of sections directly in front of me. I do see some folks with some old Cotton Miles jerseys and from every iteration, whether from the old East Coast Hockey League days, which actually is when Tom Callahan would have first set foot in this building. I was with the Augusta Lynx back in the day in the ECHL. Of course, now both of those teams are long gone. But we'll get things underway here with Wilson wheeling it on back, and it looks like Team Star, he's going to set it up here. Here's Boomer coming in right side. B-Sharp with the backdoor feed. Did not quite catch up. And there's a centering attempt that goes right through the crease out the other side. Scoring Oren Hergott, keeping it in there. Puck deflected on down. Prefontaine coughs it up at center. Bichard coming back, playing a little defense here. And Boom lost it in his own zone. Here's Keller on the left side, trying to flip it in front. A shot and the initial save, no rebound. Nice job there, Vijay, making the save. So it's going to be, I believe, two 20-minute runtime halves. And getting to see some of the legends out there. You know what was great about the morning skate today was some of these guys had their kids out there with them on the ice who were old enough to play or had the interest in the game. And getting out there to skate with their dads, it was a pretty neat thing to see. It was a lot of fun and a great morning for hockey here in Columbus. And I got to tell you, great crowd here for this Legends game. There is still time. If you want to come down and see the Legends game, your ticket for tonight's River Dragons game gets you in the door for both of these. So right now, there's three number sevens on both of these teams. So it's either Zemlichka, Maldonado, or Johnson at any one time if they're wearing a white jersey here. As that one will be moved ahead, Zemlichka couldn't hang on to it. Johnson, another number seven with it, centers. And that one is knocked away behind the net. Now there's also three number sevens on Team Pepsi, the dark team. You have Haggerty, Frazier, and Armstrong. I thought we were going to be a little liberal on the offsides there, but we are not. Paul Frazier just kind of lollygagging there at the line. Come on, Paul. You got to get that puck in. Especially when some of these guys get up the momentum. They don't want to stop the momentum. They're just going to keep right on trucking. Team Pepsi will win that faceoff back and try to move it on in. And, well, here they come up the right side. In with a chance. Oh, Vijay was caught from behind by Johnson there. Pardon me. That was one of the number 26s. I believe that was Vanelli who was caught from behind. But now Johnson will try to move it ahead for Team Starry. Starry will try to wheel things in front here and unable to come up with that one was Maldonado. Here's a backhand up right through the slot. That one was knocked away. I don't even know who that is, 24. That's one of the late additions, I imagine. Here's Lewis back in for Starry. Stahl with a shot. That one is sticked away in front. And so because both of Team Pepsi's goalies both wear number one, I'm not entirely sure if that's Lowen or Rutledge. I imagine it's Lowen. It is Lowen. We have confirmation. Rutledge will probably play the second half here if he's available. Boy, the benches are pretty packed here, too, for this Legends game. And, you know, and a lot of the players come back here, and Jerome Bichard said it this morning, a lot of the guys, they don't necessarily miss the playing, but they miss the camaraderie, they miss the team, they miss being in the dressing room and, you know, being around the guys. Puck ends up in the slot. Here's a chance towards the net. That one is shoved wide. Keeping it in on the right side there. Stahl trying to move it in front. Ends up at left point. Frazier, a shot. Vijay save. And it's kicked away in front. Jenstad crashing the crease. He's got it in the corner. Centering again. There's another shot. And they score. Team Pepsi on the board first. I believe that one is going to Mann. Did a man or Hammond? We got a couple of 17s. I think that was Mann that scored that one. I have zero help on confirmation for the production staff. Zero. Left to wait for the call of the goal. It's kind of funny. Just looking at the duplicate numbers on the roster and how many of them there are. As I told you, there's three number sevens on both teams, and there are other duplicate numbers as well. So it's going to be a lot of fun to try to keep up with that. It's like high school football. You got three number 12s out there somehow. Pepsi will move it ahead again onto the right wing side. They're going to push in into the slot. That one is hooked well wide by McMonagle there. Caresti's keeping it in. He'll feed to the back door. Tipped in behind the net by Green. Out the near side to the left point. Caresti's on it again to the right point. There's a shot coming in. Vigier the save. Puck turned over in the slot area. Bichard trying to battle it out of there. That's up on the near wall and again to the right point. Frazier will let it go again. That one's tipped to the glass. This time it finds Adam Vanelli. He'll move that one ahead. And now here comes Team Starry on the left side. Vanelli going to the net with a chance, and he scores. There you go, Adam Vanelli. Well, actually, correction, that might have been Marchand with the goal there. They were up 2-on-1 together. I thought that was Vanelli's goal. However, again, we'll wait for the call. Nope, it is Vanelli. I don't know how many assists we're going to dole out, if any, here. Pepsi pushes back in. Vigier with a save there. Rebound is swatted away by Prefontaine. Puck in behind the net, put up top. And again, Vigier makes the stop. He'll hold on. Boy, he's been busy here in the early going. Ouellette's the other goaltender for Team Starry. He will play in the second half. And I've been informed that Jarrett Rutledge was unable to make it for the weekend. So we've got a three-goaltender rotation going on. So I hope Lowen is in shape. He's got the whole game. Puck turned over. Here's Haggerty with a chance in front and a right pad save on the doorstep there. Marchand denied by Vigier. Back comes Bowles. He'll move it in for Team Starry. Puck to the net and a glove save. Nice stop right there by Lowen. And now we've got a little bit of a scrum in the corner. Hatch pulls it out, puts it in front. Loa knocked it away, and Hergott put it right across the front of the net. Ends up at the right point. As Team Starry going to work offensively, there's a shot. Nice save right on the doorstep. Loam with the left pad. Wilson, left side, into the slot. Another shot, shoulder save. Puck right up in the air. Batted away to the corner. And that's played down with a high stick. We'll get a whistle and a face-off back down in the other end of the ice. So again, it's a running clock. And we've played about 8 minutes into this 20-minute half. 1-1 between Pepsi and Starry. Team Pepsi is the dark uniforms, and Team Starry the light. River Dragons locking up the FPHL title last night as well as the Continental Division title last night. Back in action tonight against the Blue Ridge Bobcats. And all the folks who are in there to watch this game, and I'm telling you, there's a couple thousand people here watching this game. This is actually pretty cool. But they're staying for the game tonight against Blue Ridge. That'll be a lot of fun. Team Pepsi with a long pass ahead at center. Mann moving up after it. Vigier's going to play it away to the near side. One of the interesting little side notes in this one is that Zimlichko, who is playing for Team Starry here in this game and is a River Dragons alumni, will be coaching Blue Ridge a little bit later on. Pepsi pushing back in. There's a puck right in front. Nice stop by BG. And now breakaway pass the other way. Here's Green moving in by himself, and he is stopped. Nice save. Lowen got the right pad down and made the stop. Maldonado pushing back in. And he tried a little toe drag there around the D, but couldn't get a shot away. Pepsi back the other way. Here they come in on the right side. Curling away is Lind. He'll put it up top. Shot in by Caresti. Isn't a solid blocker save there. Johnson couldn't clear. And now Pepsi going to work again. Frazio up top. Just puts it towards the net. Deflected on the way in wide. Caresti's trying to keep it in. At the line, pushed out off of Stahl. Maldonado trying to turn the Jets on at center here, but he was caught from behind there by Lind. Pepsi on the regroup, up the left side. They'll bring it in. Chance in front, and that one is tipped in behind the net. Hooked into the corner, poked behind. Right to Lind. Lind on the right side, he'll move it ahead. And unable to come up with it was Vanelli, maybe doing a little bit of goal hanging out there at center. Whoop, there's a big old hook right there from Stahl. Back comes Starry in with a chance and a blocker save there for Lowen. Lind elects to put it up the right side. That's turned over to Vanelli at center. And right now, both teams just kind of cycling through players out there. Keller blocked that pass up the middle of the ice. Here's one on the right side to Vanelli. He'll move it ahead. Whoop, diving at the line. Unable to make the play. It was Baylor. Oh, backhand cross-ice feed, and they score. Vanelli's got his second. Vanelli, nice shot from the off angle there. Actually, that was Wilson, by the way, who just went full, like, sprawl right at the blue line trying to make that play. Almost made it. About 8:10 to go here in this first half. It's now 2-1 Starry. Adam Vanelli with a pair of goals. Tullian chasing it back. It's moved up the wall and now ahead, Jenstad into space on the left wing, turned away from Keller. McMonagle sending it back. He'll get it and move in. On the wing, in with a shot off the crossbar. Oh, my. That one solid off the pipe. Right back in comes Pepsi. Here's Keller. Right side looking for McMonagle. Carries it behind. Now he, oh, here we go. Here we go. Bichard and Wilson. Bichard got jerseyed already. Wilson trying to get in there. Bichard back with a left. Wilson with some rights over the top. And they end up hugging it out. Wilson and Bichard will have a seat. Boomer's got to collect himself and his gear on his way into the penalty box. Ah, the fans love it. And then you have to love that a fan with a Wilson jersey goes over and says hi into the penalty box. That's fantastic. That's awesome. I'll tell you what, everybody, we talk about this a lot. There is a very long, very rich hockey tradition here in Columbus. It goes back almost 30 years. And this is definitely a place that loves its teams, remembers, and celebrates it. Jenstad back in on the right side here, and now Team Starry back the other way up the right side. Here's Lewis. Puts it into the high slot area. Shot towards the net. That's sticked away there by Lowen. Flip to the line and just gets over. Puck sent down the ice. Are they going to wave? Nope. They don't wave off the icing here. They just take the icing. They'll take their little breather while they can and then get the face off in the offensive zone. Might be dusting off some of the hits from back in the day of Columbus hockey. Because this disc, this is Driving and Crying, Fly Me Courageous. This definitely came out when I was in high school. So we're talking early 90s here. Here's Lewis around to the far side. He'll hook it ahead, and now moving into the right wing. A shot, and that one is blasted wide on the stick side by Baylor. Back the other way. Team Pepsi with a chance up the right side. In on goal, and nice defense there out of Prefontaine. As he took that chance away from, well, one of the 17s. Is it Mann or Hammond? I'll have to see who's wearing the red helmet here in a minute. Ooh, Lowen getting adventurous, coming away out to play the puck. So it looks like Hammond is number 17 in the red helmet. He was the one with the scoring chance. It's a lead pass. Hammond on the left side. Moves it across. A little give and go here at the line. And that one is snuffed out by Zemlitska. But it's stolen back. Haggerty to Hammond. High slot. Wanted Haggerty again. And that one is dumped out. Caresti's getting back, putting the puck across. And now there's a stretch. That one tipped in. Vigier's got to come out and play it. A little sneaky right there. Backhands it around the near side. Under 4 minutes to go in this first half. It is 2-1 Team Starry. Starry in the light jerseys. Team Pepsi in the black. There's a shot. Ooh, whipped by the ear. That one ends up in the near side corner. And Stahl did not see the puck coming, but that's all right. Right behind him, it's picked up and dumped across here by Green. There's a chance that Johnson is knocked away into the corner. Crimmin centered, and that one, oh, three on one the other way here. Here they come up that left wing side. There's a shot, and the save made by the right pad of Vigier. That was Mann on the right wing. Probably wanted to get a little more mustard behind that one, but sometimes the off-speed pitch works as well. Shot from the right wing is handled and held by Ouellette. Man, he's getting a little love down there in front. Crimmin letting that one go from the right side. Wilson and Bichard out of the box. And Bichard is coming over to the dressing room. Boy, you don't like to see that, unless this is planned, of course. Boone might be taking some time off. He's got a game to coach later. Actually, he's over there kind of hobnobbing right now, so. You know, it's amazing, and it's Jerome who puts this whole thing together. Boomer does this entire thing. He gets all the alumni together, organizes the whole shtick, gets the game, gets everybody to commit to coming down and being a part of things here for this game every year, and just so much work goes into it, so many hours that are all volunteer hours. It's not like it's a paid gig, but he does it because he loves the team, loves the town, and loves the game. There's a bank pass that goes all the way down the ice and playing it away from Crimmin, Ouellette to Wilson. And now Pepsi will break out the other way. Lead pass at center is picked off, and now Starry coming back in. Whoop, offside. Idolski had a good lead over the line there, but his teammates just couldn't quite get their way back out over the blue line. So I expect we'll probably see Ouellette in the second half. Coming up on a minute to go in the first half here. And as I mentioned earlier, it looks like Lowen's got the whole game to himself here. Rutledge unable to make it. And now here's a scoring chance for Pepsi. In on the right wing. Backdoor feed. Didn't quite connect. Vigier got aggressive. Went for the poke check. And now back comes Team Starry. Under a minute to go. Vanelli's already got two. Looking for three. Couldn't get a shot away. But there's a chance in front. And that one is knocked away to the corner. Good chance there for Pallardy. And now diving way out, Lowen with the poke check. Puck at the far side is cleared out. Down the ice it'll go. And up, we are going to have a little bit of a race here. Amos putting some pressure on, put it right in front. Vigier steering it away. 20 seconds to go. That's kept in up top. On to the right side, across ice feed, blocked, bouncer away from Mann. And I believe that is Baird down there, Lind in front, trying to move it away. And that's going to do it for the first half. Vanelli kind of ran out of time there and maybe ran out of gas too, but that's all the fun here. These guys out here playing, they're going to maybe take a quick break. Nope. I'm trying to remember if last year, and I believe he did, I think Jerome Bichard addressed the crowd talking a little bit, but I don't remember if that was halfway through or, well, no, he's got the microphone. So let's go ahead and turn it over to Boom and hear what he's got to say.
Dana, thank you. Hey, guys. All the damn things going on. Gonna catch up with some of these guys, see what's going on in their lives, see where they live. Let's start with number 10, Jordan Gray. Where are you living nowadays? There you go, Jordan Green. Matt Ventura, how's what have been with Nova to meet you?
Nice and good.
And what's going on with the family?
Named it Georgia.
Nice work. Dougie Mack, how was that? How was the first period there?
Not bad, just getting the legs going. One thing for a better second period here, but we're undefeated in the weekend and don't have any goals for it. And just hoping that we can make sure that we're going to run some more
perspective. Where's Tom Wilson? Every time we do this, are you bleeding? That was it.
Yeah, that's blood on his lip. I'm going to have two marks on my face, though.
What's up with Tom Wilson now, then?
Just getting on getting married in the fall. Okay, yeah, love it. Beautiful girl, can't wait. That car park, same line.
Nice. Mr. Pauly Friso, what's going on in your life?
I sell suits at the National Tennessee.
Nice. Good to be back in Columbus.
Love for the home. Thanks, fellas.
Andrew Lowen.
Jerome Bichard.
What's going on with Lowen?
We're in Columbus, Ohio. Shout out to Aflac. Working with Aflac. We got Aflac people here. Couple. Love it.
We'll probably see you a little later. What we got? Alex Crowley. What's going on in your life? Nick Curry is still single, ladies. I don't know. Pretty good. I think he's got a good job. He's a good looking dude. Ryan Haggerty.
Look how good that is.
Brett Hammond.
Living in Minnesota, 6-year-old boy playing hockey. Great to be back and see all friendly faces here.
Tyler Keller.
Living in Penrose, Alberta. Got my wife and boy and Mike Smith still playing hockey. Hockey and your hockey.
Do I see the Jagger? Are you guys the Jagger guys?
Maybe. It's Jagger.
I call him Jared because I don't respect him. Tough guy. McMonagle.
Yeah, life was good. Living in Houston, Texas. Good to be back here in Columbus.
Mr. Cam Green. Jimmy Kreske, English please.
Everybody, keep up with work. people. Great to see all these guys. Living at home in Toronto. Married 10 years. Daughter, son. Life is good. Great to be back. Thank you to one of them.
Adam Benelli, where you been? What's going on?
Hello, Minnesota. What you know? It's good to see the terrible winter. We come back down here. It's nice and sunny. We're doing this way. It's good to see everybody. Love to be back here. And let's score on ball for Joe as many times as we can today.
Kyle Johnson.
After leaving Columbus, I went back home to Edmonton, Alberta, and with me here today is my beautiful partner in crime, David Ellis.
Mike Martin.
It's always good to be back. I'm very close to that. I'm going to do my last skate, but I want to say thanks to the wonderful ladies that are up there that are taking care of us tonight. A wonderful time that I've had here. I owe you guys a whole heck of a lot. Thank you very much.
Tommy Longanato.
Living here in Phoenix City, Columbus. I want to say hi to some friends and clients in the section over there. And a special hello to Blaine Longanato.
We got Brock Johnson. How are you doing nowadays?
I'm good. Yeah, I'm doing very well, Joel. Scotty C. back there. Wherever you are, Scotty.
Derek Florida.
Hey, great to be back. First time. Got my wife, Madison. Daughter, wife, Winston. Say hi to
them. Ian BJ.
Hello.
First R so far right now, again.
I don't think so.
I don't know. Brian Ikowski.
Beach.
Good time. Is that everybody? I guess they're ready to play hockey. See if we can't not get beat up today. Brian Aitken, how are you? Good, okay.
Okay, we're back underway here for the second half of action. And so you might have heard there, Ouellette is on the bench here. Vijay's getting the whole game, and he just made a big stop there as we come back to action. And so it is a Lowen and Vijay showdown here on the ice. Right now, the River Dragons of Cottonmouths alumni playing to a 2-1 game here so far. So Team Starry is the white team in the white Legends jerseys. Here's Vanelli. He's got both goals, looking for the hat trick, missed on the glove side. Now back the other way. Feed on the right wing. McMonagle across, left up top in the slot, and whoop, Vijay down early, but shot blocked on the way in. Tumbles just wide in front of him. Baylor will pull it out of there for Team Starry. Swept ahead on the right wing. Here's Oren Hergott. Hergott moving in. His shot, save made, and the rebound held by Lowen. Oh, here we go. We'll get the pile up behind the net. Karestes is in there, trying to give it the old underneath hook. These guys love to give each other the business. It's fun to see. Faceoff will come to the right of the Team Pepsi goal. They'll move that puck ahead on the right side. There's a chance at Vichy just getting a piece of that wrist shot there by Gingera. We'll try to put that one in towards the slot. It ends up hooked down to the left side. Gets it right back in front. Little give and go. Vijay, couple of big left pad saves. Not out of danger yet, though. Pepsi continues to press. Puck ends up at the left point. Now to the right side. Shot coming in. Vijay save again. Stopped with the rebound on the doorstep, and he holds on. They look sharp down there. Faceoff will be to the right of the Team Starry cage. Just under 15 minutes to go here in this second half. 2-1, Team Starry in the lead. Right now, Team Pepsi putting on the pressure, looking for a tying goal here. I don't know if they go to a shootout, but I don't know if they play OT. I think they might just go to a shootout if they are tied. Here's Starry up on the right side. They'll feed it back across, a tip into the slot, taken away there. And now Pepsi up the right side. Curry leaves it into the slot. A shot, and again, Vijay with the save. Boy, the instincts are still there. Comes out on the angle, tries to be aggressive, make himself big, take that shot away. Puck at the right point. Tullian walks in. He shoots and hit the goalpost, and it shoots out of play. The second post in this game for Team Pepsi, and it stays 2-1 Starry. Faceoff comes outside the zone. Team Pepsi will control. And they'll bring it back in on the left side. Man tried to center. Puck ends up in the left side corner. Lind puts it up top. Schopp coming in. Save made. Rebound to the near side. Is picked up. Trying to wheel it out of danger is Johnson. He does get it up the left side. Zemlichka. Moving it back to the D, and now a little cross-ice pass knocked out of the air by Frejo. They call a play with a high stick. Faceoff will be just outside that Team Starry blue line. I want to remind everybody, the River Dragons and the Blue Ridge Bobcats tonight, 7:05. 6:30 on the Air Force Heating and Air pregame show. Hope you can join us for that. Puck back to the left point. Shot by Prefontaine is stopped by Lowen. Hasn't had much to do here in this period. Pepsi's been on the attack. They'll bring it in on the left side. Here's a chance. Frazier walking in. Vijay again. The save in tight. Working his way towards first star honors in this one. Face off to the right of the Team Starry net. And Eventually, Starry ends up with this puck. Bichard off his skate. Lowen's got to come out and play it. Flings it around to the near side. Team Pepsi trying to leave the zone. Up the right side, here they come. Pass missed. Now Bichard on it. At center. Moved ahead, Vanelli. Couldn't get there ahead of Lowen. And that's the most action Lowen's had here in this period, just having to play the puck. Now there's a big lead at center. Zhenstab moving in, trying to cut through the D, and he is hugged into the corner by Prefontaine. Down to the ice they go. That's the best hit we've seen all day. Now back comes Pepsi. Oh, Zhenstab couldn't get out. And Haggerty kept going. Play goes offside. Plenty of folks here to watch the Legends play. Face-off is controlled by Team Starry. They'll look to move it up the left side here. Starry's got the 2-1 lead. Chance in front, Hergott right on the doorstep. Lowen diving out to try to get to the puck. He does corral it and hang on with 10 minutes left to go in the half. Eventually, once Lowen gets back into the net, we'll have a face-off here, but he went for a stroll. Now he's back. And the puck up top, kept in there by Maldonado. Centering attempt, that would have swatted away in front. Pepsi looking to break the zone. Here's Keller. Pass ahead. McMonagle, and all the way back in on goal it comes. Maldonado trying to wheel away from danger. Looking for a little bit of help. He just flings it to an open wing, and it's scooped up there on the left side. Starry pushing in here. They're up 2-1. Wouldn't mind a little insurance, I'm sure. There's a backhand pass in front. Ooh, Lowen caught it out of the air. Tried to play it ahead, but ended up tied up. And his defenseman was right there, though. They play it back the other way. Lead passer Keller didn't quite reach him. Now turning it back in. There's Bowles, right side. Hey, he was looking for a penalty there, and he's going to get it. I think they're giving him, do they give him penalty shots? Or do they make him sit in the box? Lewis goes over and says hello to Wilson. I don't know. They make him sit? Yeah, they're going to make him sit. Wilson into the box for Team Pepsi. That's his second trip to the bin here. He fought Jerome Bichard in the first half. And now here in the second half, he's going to take a seat, and we get a rare Team Starry power play. But Pepsi pushes ahead, and they're going to look shorthanded here. There's a little flip into space. Oh, boy, just was knocked out of the air. And Starry able to go the other way. Moore putting it up on the right side, rattled in around the glass. Hergott couldn't come up with it. Pepsi the other way. They're going to try for a little chance here on the right wing. Back in front, and that pass did not connect. As Wydalski got the hook in there to prevent the chance. I'll tell you what, Pepsi's aggressive on this shorthanded forecheck here. Two guys deep. But Starry is finally able to get it to center here. 1 minute to go on the power play for Team Starry. Lewis in the high slot, feeds it to the right point. Cross ice again back for Lewis, and that did not connect with him. Ends up at the left point. Moore, his shot hit Hergott, ends up in the far corner. Now into the slot again, went through the skates of Lewis. Turned on the left side. Chance in front. Ooh, tip just wide of the post. Hergott was planted right in front, and now break the other way. Here's Kurien shorthanded, in on goal, and he slides it wide on the backhand. River Dragons back the other way. Ha, River Dragons. How about Team Starry? I guess technically there are some River Dragons who went the other way there. That's how I'm going to play it. That's what we're going with. Power play coming to a close here for Starry. They lead it 2-1. Coming up on 6.5, or actually just past 6.5 minutes left in the half. As Crimmin gives a little extra to Mann. And faceoff will come up next to Bijay. Boy, he's had himself a heck of a game. The old Cottonmouth's color pads on. Faceoff is controlled by Pepsi, though. Here's a shot coming in, driven just wide by Wilson, who has since gotten out of the penalty box. But now turned ahead, and Starry has numbers. Now it's 2-on-2, 3-on-3, but Crimmin caught from behind. And now back pushes Pepsi on the right wing side. They'll work it in on goal. They score. Oh, a little excuse me leave behind by Gingera. And he gets the left pad of Vijay away from the post. In it goes. And we're tied at 2. A nice little bit of stick work right there. Faceoff coming up on the dot at center. And Pepsi has its momentum now. Back up the left side, here's Zemlichka pushing in. He'll try to put it in front. Couldn't slide the pass through. Puck almost came right back to him. Instead, Pepsi the other way, motoring ahead. Here they come up on the left wing and curling away on that far side over there is Lind. He'll put it behind the net. And a centering feed. Jenstad right in on goal. Vijay had to hang on to that one. So about 4 minutes left in this runtime second half. 2-2 your score between Pepsi and Starry. It's been a low scoring affair, I think, compared to last year. If I remember correctly, it was more like a 7-2 game last year. So here comes Team Starry. Vanelli playing it ahead. Back on the left side. There's a chance, and that would have sticked away by Lowen as Baylor couldn't get it to go. And, whoop, turned over in the slot. Vanelli hooked it across, but coughed it up there. It's flipped back out to center. 3:15 left. Schneider up on the left side with it. Actually, that might be Lind, the other 19. Frazio at the right point, holding on. His chance is deflected in front. Didn't get to Jenstad. Vanelli getting it back quickly here. He has to move up the left side. There comes Vanelli in over the line. Try to walk in front. Knocked away. Back comes Team Pepsi up the right side. Haggerty chasing. In on the backhand. That's deflected behind the net by Johnson. On to the right point. Tallying in with a shot, right pad saved, big rebound, not out of danger yet. Wilson lets it go, that's deflected, never made it on goal. About 2.5 to go, centering feed, Vijay knocked that one away. It ends up in the far side corner. Team Starry ahead looking for Bichard, but he was tied up from behind there. I think Wilson caught him trying to goal hang a little bit there. No icing as it's flipped back down the ice. Whoa, now a giveaway at the side of the net. Puck ends up in the high slot area. Here's Haggerty to the left side. And now flip into the far circle. Here comes Team Starry back up the left wing. Johnson tried to walk it in from the left wing side. That one knocked around to the far side and ends up with Haggerty. And it's stolen away down low. I'll tell you what, Starry's pushing right now. They're looking for one more. Puck ends up at the right point. A shot pinballs out, and it's kept in, sent to an open wing there by Idolski. But now Team Pepsi going the other way. Here they come in the right side. Green with a backhand across, and that one missed. The Pepsi pushing here as we approach 1 minute to go in the second and final half. But here is Oren Hergott ahead. He's up, has help. Driving to the net, cutting it on goal, save low, and rebound is stopped as well. And the puck behind the net. And now it's fired the length of the ice, hopped over Frazio. Vigier's got to hang on to it. No, he elects to play it away. It's getting a little wide open here. We go 2-on-1 the other way again. And now a chance on the right side. Lewis has to curl up looking for help. We've actually seen some pretty good goaltending in this game. Now the puck given away, and McMonagle back up the left side for Team Pepsi. Looking in the slot, feeds it to Green, couldn't get a shot away. Puck in behind McMonagle. Boy, you can tell all of a sudden the pace picked up here. 2 minutes left. Oh, turnover in the slot. Here's a chance. Moved a shot, and Karestes is stopped by the right pad of Vigier. That suddenly got competitive. 20 seconds to go. Here's Hergott. On to the right side, moving it in over the line. A little give-and-go action to the left wing. Lewis tried to shove it in front, and it bounces away to the far corner. Puck behind the net, centered. Karesti's there to take it away, and that's going to do it. We are going to end regulation tied at 2. Boy, the last 2 minutes of that game was exactly the Toby Keith song, I ain't as good as I once was, but I'm as good once as I ever was. And that once was that last 2 minutes right there. Everybody that was out on that last shift was really giving it everything. 2-2 tie, Pepsi and Starry. So I think we're going to a shootout, but first, we got to have a little dancing at center ice here. It's time for the wobble. See Andrew Lowe and get out there and do the wobble. Everybody loves it. Drives everybody crazy here in Columbus. They love the throwbacks, the callbacks. They love the hockey history here. Let's see, are we going to overtime or shootout? How are we going to do this, guys? Looks like they're going to do OT. All right, let's play till we get a winner. Yep, and it's 5-on-5. All right, let's do it. Or are we doing 3 20-minute runtime periods this year? I think we're just doing overtime. I think we're doing overtime. They didn't cut the ice. Let's see what happens here. In with a shot, and immediately Beach has to make a save. Here's Wilson at the left point, sending it in towards the slot. That one is knocked away. You know what we'll know when we get our first goal here. Right now, Team Pepsi on the regroup, trying to stretch it up the right side, and they come in 2-on-1. There's a chance in the right wing. Oh, the puck just rolling away there from Mann. He's hooked up in behind the net. Still comes out with it, though. Centers. And a shot. That one across the goal mouth, out the other side. Fed to the left point. Wilson towards the net. Deflected away in front. Pepsi holding it deep here for a moment. But Starry now on the regroup. Trying to wheel through center. Here they come to the left wing side. Starry in over the line. Trying to spin through that was Crimmin. Didn't quite work out. Pepsi has to go back for it. Hammond leaving it off now onto the left side. Here's a chance for... Well, actually, I'm not entirely sure who that is. Okay, that's another number 19. I'm not sure that I have. Maybe that's more? Vanelli back for Starry, tried to hook it across, ends up in the far side corner. Caresti's after it. It ends up near side again. Here's Vanelli with a chance off the goal post. Another shot coming in. That one is blocked in front. So now two posts for Pepsi and one for Starry. Back in on the left side. Here's a chance in on goal. Vigier sticks that away. Vanelli on it, trying to go up the left wing. Looked to feed it ahead towards Bichard. And it's sent back in. Vigier out to trap it behind the net. Look out. Here's Prefontaine. Oh, he looked like he was going to rev it up for a run, but then made a pass ahead. Ends up down the ice. Lowen comes out to negate the icing. Haggerty in trouble in his own end. Maldonado on him. As he looks to put that one ahead. Caresti's tipping it on into space. Here's Pepsi up the left side. Crimmin with it at the line. Does get it in, sends it to an open wing, but Johnson will end up with it. And Starry looks to regroup quickly here. Feed through center, just coughed up, ends up all the way back in front of the Pepsi bench. Puck in the Starry end here. Johnson run into there by McMonagle. He tried to center, but it's turned the other way, and now up the left wing side, here comes Starry. Feed into the slot, Maldonado to the backhand, right in on goal, and Lowen will hold that, get the whistle. And the faceoff will go to his left. Lewis chased down to the draw by Bowles. He says, I got this, tries to go ahead with the faceoff. Goes in behind the net, Talion. Ends up on the right side with it, and that goes out to center. Maldonado turning it back in on the right wing, and here come Starry once again. Puck to the near dot. A backside feed did not connect. Around to the left point, Johnson holds it in on the backhand. As it's cleared, and now a break. Here's a breakaway for Pepsi, moving in a shot. Vigier with the save on McMonagle. I think he's wrapped himself up for Star Honors, win or lose. He's had a pretty good game out there. Vigiel moving over Bichard. Up to center. Bowles moving in, feeds it across. Here's a chance and a nice glove saved by Lowen. And the pushing and shoving in front. Surprise, surprise. Number 16 finds his way to the front of the net. Boom, boom. Getting right to the crease. And And Bichard hooked up, couldn't get to that puck. And, I mean, he was well hooked. Pepsi floats it back in right side. Here's a shot on goal. Saviche, puck away to the corner. Round to the right point, held in again. Haggerty bounced one in on goal. And again, Vigier saved with a tip in front. Now a chance. Oh, what a stop on the doorstep right there as he takes it away from Marchand. And now back the right wingers. Bulls moving in, looking in front. Glove save Lowen. Boy, the goaltenders have been on point. Bichard with a drive. Lowen save, reaching out, and finally the rebound put home. It's scoring Oren Hergott with the goal that puts Starry in front 3-2. Lowen trying to say, hey, there was goalie interference there, folks. That is no goal. Lowen doing a demonstration of what he believes happened by throwing himself to the ice, and then he puts the puck on the faceoff dot to his left. But they're going to call it a goal. I don't care what game it is, the referees are always wrong. Even when they're right, they're wrong. Columbus fans are just warming up for later. Might I suggest to our referees they visit the optical shop in Phoenix City? Uh-oh. Wilson came up to mess with Matthews a little bit. Or Martins, pardon me. Martins will push in on the right side for Team Starry. Hergott with the goal. Puck at the right point is held in there and ends up in the near corner. And whoop, Pepsi, 3-on-0 the other way. Here they go. It's fed ahead to Mann. He's up by himself. And Vigier, right pad save. A backdoor feed again. Vigier to his left. The stop. Puck still free behind the net. Pepsi at a 3-on-0. Here's another chance in, and they score. Tallien finally puts it home to tie it up for Pepsi. It's 3-3. Well, just when you thought this one looked like it had been turned back to Starry, Pepsi jumps right back with a response. So now back the other way is Pepsi on the left side as it's poked away from Haggerty out to center. There's a chance in the slot. That one is knocked away, and it ends up on the far side with Stahl. And now, whoop, Vanelli on the left side steals the puck, moves in for Starry to the backhand off the crossbar. He's on his own rebound. A little thump on the near side here between Stahl and Hammond. Puck behind the net. Pepsi trying to find something here to get it out of the zone. Ends up at the left point. Shot by Prefontaine deflects wide. Stahl put it into the slot. Vanelli a shot. Glove save Lowen, and he elects to hang on. Faceoff will be to the left of that Team Pepsi net. It ends up at the point. Shot comes right back in, wide on the stick side. But now Pepsi ahead looking for the break. Here's Green on the right side, wheeling off, feeds it into the slot, but it was behind Keller. And now back the other way. Here comes Team Starry. Puck in the left side corner, but Pepsi got back to take it away. And now Keller moving it ahead to Green. Green in over the line. Backhands it in front, and that's played away by Vigier. Starry looking to move the puck out. Right side, here's Lewis. In over the Team Pepsi line. Flipping it down low on it. Bulls. It ends up behind the net. Bulls on the near side. 3-3 tie. Starry and Pepsi. Team Starry trying to go to work here. Chance in front, Bull, shot, save made, rebound, back door, oh, off the post again. An open net there. And Lewis hit the goal post, and I'll tell you what, that post has been bailing out both goalies at times tonight. At times, both goalies have been fantastic. It's been a really entertaining game. And now we get a penalty, delayed penalty coming up for Starry. Here's Hergott, weaving on the left side, feeds it in front. Tip just wide of the post. Extra skater is out there as he'll go to work setting it up here. Here's Hergott wheeling up high with it. Onto the left side, pushed away into the corner. Martin's trying to catch up with it. Hergott near side, and a save made by Lowen, and he hangs on. Hey, well, Lowen's got to be in the conversation for Stars as well. And, of course, you got Vanelli with two goals. Legends of Columbus Hockey. So I guess we're not doing halves. We're doing periods. Got about 11 and a half minutes running time to go here in this third period. Starry onto the power play. As Green goes into the box. Not entirely sure for what, but sure he did something. Puck at the right point, here's Moore to Hergott on the right wing. They're actually setting up a power play here. Hergott run into in the corner, more like knocked down. The puck in the slot and a chance to clear here. Pepsi's gonna say, we'll skate it out. There's a pass ahead there. Moore reaching back to tip it away. And now Starry up 3-on-2 here as they move it in. High slot. Bichard up top with it. His shot in on goal. A chance. Oh, splitting out to his right. Lowen forced the shot wide. I tell you what, that is an agile move. Still got it. Pepsi on it. They'll try to clear it down. Maybe looking for a shorthanded chance here, but it's gloved down to center. Turn right back. Here they come in now on the left wing side. Maybe a chance jumping and unable to get through the D there was Hergott. Hergott on the loose puck. Fed it to the slot. Tapped away there as Vanelli tried to jump in. Instead, Pepsi just takes it on down the ice with about 20 seconds to go in the penalty. Starry with one last rush. Here comes Adam Vanelli. Puck tipped on over the line. Bouncer in the high slot area. Taken away. And that should do it for that Team Starry power play. Pepsi has killed it off. Puck goes in on goal. Vigier the save. And he'll hang on. 9.5 minutes to go in this third period. 3-3 Starry and Pepsi. And right off the faceoff, Starry takes it ahead, moves it out of the zone. Left side, it's turned away back to center. And now moving up with it, Hammond at the line. Knocked back by Starry. They'll come in. Onto the right side of the Team Pepsi. And here's Mlechka moving in on goal. He scores! So Zemi's got himself a goal as he tucks it past the right pad of Lowen. And Starry takes a 4-3 lead with under 9 minutes to go, and all of a sudden the clock has been stopped. We're getting a little intense here again, I think. You can pretty much make up whatever rules you want. I mean, you want run time, you want stop time. But the alumni, I mean, they love it. They love being out there. They're having a good time with it. But I tell you what, it's going to get competitive here down the stretch. Maldonado, left side. He'll move it across. Here's a chance in on goal. Save made, and the rebound pushed away to the far side. And now back the other way. Here's Haggerty wheeling it in over the line, trying to leave it off. And Schenstad pushed it into the left side corner. Maldonado will flip that one away to center. Carestes is back on defense here. Starry attacks, and nice job there just to tie up his man on the far side. Pepsi back again. They'll try the left side here. There's a shot. VJ save, hugging that right post as Moore let it go. Or actually, pardon me, that is Lind, I believe. Banked up to the left point. Puck kept in by Frazio. Back down to Haggerty. Haggerty into the left side corner. He gets it back at the near dot. Tees one up. Vijay the save. Stahl sends it around to the near side. Starry trying to clear the zone. They do. Puck at the line. Starry able to keep it in. Oh, Hergott just missed. A little breakaway attempt in close there. Lowen had to come out and play the puck away. Pepsi the other way. Right side, here's a chance. Lifted over top of the net by Green. Starry up 3-on-2. Into the high slot, wrist shot, glove, save Lowen. Lowen trying to catch Starry sleeping defensively here, feeds it ahead quickly. Back comes Team Pepsi on the right side, but the lead for man did not get to him, and Wilson quickly back. Or pardon me, Baylor back for Starry. And this pass missed the mark. And down it goes. VJ's going to allow for the icing this time, not coming out to play it. Again, a reminder that here on this Legends of Columbus Hockey Weekend, the River Dragons tonight taking on the Blue Ridge Bobcats. 7:05 start, 6:30 on the Air Force Heating and Air pregame show. We'll have it for you right here on the YouTube channel. And on 106.9 Rocks, plus if you're in the local area, come on and join us here at the Columbus Civic Center. There's a shot in on goal, Vigier with a save. Bichar after it, play it around the wall, up to the left point, Wilson long shot off the tip of the mitt. Goes to the right point. Kept in there. Pepsi another chance. Fiji. Oh, off his arm and in. And now we're tied at 4. 5.5 minutes to go in this third period. And these two teams neck and neck with one another. Face-off will be pushed ahead by Pepsi. Keller in on the right wing. There's another chance, and that's knocked away in front. Keller getting credit for the goal. Here's Lewis backing over the line for Starry. Shoved to the front of the net, ends up towards that near side corner. And right now, it's Starry behind for the first time. Actually, we're tied back up. I don't think Starry has trailed, actually, in this game. But Pepsi's trying to make it that way. He'll bring it the other way. Here's Keller. He's filling it a little bit here, leaving it off into the high slot. Fake shot. And delivered up top. No chance coming there, though, however, as Marchand was tied up. And Starry will actually dump it in and go for a change. Well, a little dump and chase here. And now here's a chance for Pepsi moving in. Oh, Johnson, look at that D. Gets back in and just absolutely just threw the old can opener on Gingera. As they go into the net together. So the threat of a shootout has been issued here over the PA by Dana Barker. We may see it. I'll be honest with you, I think we'll probably see it anyway. At the end of the game, if this is a one-goal game, you will definitely see the entire other team's bench out there trying to score. And there are a lot of guys on those benches. Pepsi will control the faceoff. They're on the power play here now.
Team starting building number 7, Kyle Johnson. 2 minutes, 4. Hooking.
Starry able to tip it out. That was one of the all-time hooks, by the way. That was a solid 2 minutes worth. He got his whole 2 minutes worth on that hook. Pepsi trying to set it up here. We're tying at 4, about 3 minutes to go here in this third period. Legends of Columbus Hockey out there on the ice right now. Pepsi moving the puck around in the power play here, but still don't have a shot. Up top, here's Frazio moving to his right. His wrister tipped up in the air and slapped away to the corner. And now it'll be fed to the far side. A little bit of pitch and catch back in the D zone here. And finally moved ahead. Zem Leechka ends up with it. He's going to move in. Looking for a shorthanded chance. Zem Leechka in. Made it through, but the puck did not. As Tallinn knocked it away from him. That's one year to year I haven't remembered. Tallinn. I got to remember that. Pepsi with time winding down in its power play. About a half minute to go. Game tied at 4. Wilson at the right point with it. He'll flip it across. Tallinn into the slot. Tip back towards the point. Hergott will pick it up. And he's going to scoot her. And down goes Hergott. Wilson threw his hands up. I didn't do anything. Yeah. maybe mimicking a bit of a dive there. The crowd liked it. These guys can get away with the fun stuff here. Have a good time, you know. But how about this now? It's 4-on-4 with a minute 56 to go. And it's 4-on-4 for 15 seconds. Then it becomes a Team Starry power play. Up the left side, here's Haggerty moving in. He'll leave it off on the wing, carrying it in behind the net. Lind out the far side, up to the slot. Tallinn with a drive. EJ blocker save. Starry to the power play. They move it up. Hergott on the right side, cutting it on goal. He spun down again, and another penalty against Pepsi. Penalty shot. What? They're going to give Scorin Orin a penalty shot against Travis Lowen. I don't even think he knows he got a penalty shot. I don't know if I agree with that call, I'll be honest with you. Well, they know now because the announcement's been made, so who's going to take it?
Looks like it's been awarded to number 11, medalist Corin Orenherga.
If I'm Lowen, I just come out with a two-pad stack slide, like right up the middle, just try to trip him. Yep, Lowen does a 360 spin and just waits for Hergott to get in on goal, and he scores. Little anticlimactic. But how about it? Hergott's got a pair now. It's 5-4. Pepsi is still shorthanded. Well, here we go. Coming down the stretch. About a minute and a half. Pepsi shorthanded the whole time. So there goes Lowen to the bench. Extra man is on. If I'm Pepsi, I try to put out a couple extra men here, and they do. So they have six out. Now they have seven. It's the oldest trick in the book. There's a shot in tight, blocked by Vijay, and we get a whistle. You can't call too many men. Come on. It was just a slow change. That's all. Slow change. Well, Pepsi tried. They did get seven guys out there when they should have had four and then five. Yeah, Lowen's got to go back in the net. So now it's 5-on-3 technically. Let's see how this is going to work here. I think the last 106, we should just see everybody on everybody. Forget about the penalties here. Let's just get everybody out there. Or we might have a coach brawl. We could have a coach brawl. Pepsi trying to push this one ahead. Starry just looking to keep it away from him. And, whoop, here we go. Oh, second puck. We've got two pucks out there. Wide open bench doors. It is absolute chaos. Here we go. And there's one goal. Starry scores once. So it's 6-4 Starry. Pepsi the other way. There's a shot. They score. It's 6-5. Where's the other puck? All right. We're going to call it. We're going to call it good. Each team scored with the extra puck. So maybe we're seeing a little bit of hockey of the future. Who knows? 6-5 your final. Team Starry will take it. And the Legends of Columbus Hockey entertain the crowd here, and everybody has a lot of fun. Great time out there. Fans love it, and a lot of phones out for the handshake line here. So we'll stay with you through the handshake line. But remember, we're back 6:30 here for Seating and Air pregame show. River Dragons and the Blue Ridge Bobcats coming up tonight. Thanks for joining us, everybody. You've been watching the Legends of Columbus Hockey here on the River Dragons YouTube page. And the main event coming up tonight in just a little bit.